The plasma gun concept is relatively simple. It consists of a barrel, a capacitor bank, and a high voltage discharge. The barrel is ionized via the high voltage discharge, which discharges at around 40,000 kilovolts. When this is done, the barrel is ionized and the capacitor bank discharges into the barrel. When this occurs, the gas inside the barrel heats up to a couple thousand degrees Kelvin and promptly pushes the bullet out at extremely high speeds.
Our original diagram shows the bullet moving at its initial velocity about to enter the block, which is swinging on a string. Our final diagram shows the bullet after it's entered the block, where it rises to a certain height that indicates its gravitational potential energy. This is represented by H, or height. We assume that the initial kinetic energy of the pendulum after being hit by the bullet is equal to the final gravitational potential energy of the whole pendulum. Therefore, the velocity of the block is equal to the root of 2 times gravity times the height of the final pendulum. We can also assume that the initial momentum of the bullet is equal to the final momentum of the bullet block system. Through substitution of these two formulas, we can find that the velocity of the bullet is equal to 1 plus the mass of the block over the mass of the bullet multiplied by the root of 2 times gravity times the final height. Our measurements determined that the mass of the block was about 0.181 kilograms. The mass of the bullet was about 0.35 grams or 0.00035 kilograms, and using pixel measurements, we were able to determine that the final pendulum height was about 0.069 meters. Using the formula we found earlier, we determined that the velocity was just under 600 meters per second. This sounds high, but through the use of some air guns, it's possible for BB pellets to easily reach 350 meters per second, so the use of the plasma cannon would absolutely make it possible to reach speeds much higher than that. The kinetic energy equation determined that the bullet had about 63 joules of energy